Hi, you're probably aware that computers speak in zeros and ones. You've heard that a lot, probably throughout your studies in computers or your experience in computers. And so that is what we call the binary language. And we want to understand a little bit about what binary is and how binary works, because eventually we're going to be doing some binary math. But first, we have to understand the binary number system. So I'm just going to do a little exercise here to count in binary and show you what counting in binary looks like as opposed to counting in decimal. And I'm going to take you through several steps, but first let's take a look at the two because there's something that confuses some people. First of all, we understand that deci means 10, and we have 10 fingers, and so the decimal system that we're familiar with probably originated from the fact that we have 10 fingers. But here's what throws people off sometimes. If I was going to count my fingers, I would probably count like this. I'd go, well, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'd say, well, I have 10 fingers. But you notice that when I counted the 10th one, there are really two symbols, two digits involved in that, a 1 and a 0. So if we're really going to count the symbols themselves, we have to start with zero to say we have 10 symbols. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 symbols. So here they are. Start zero here. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, well, it looks like I only have 9 fingers here. Well, no, the 10th one is this zero. And so that can throw people off. And the same thing occurs in the binary number system. But you'll get used to it. You'll see this eventually. You'll get used to the fact that that zero is there and counts as a digit. It just takes a little bit of time. And hopefully we'll put some of that to rest today, and it will become more natural for you. Just trust me on that. Now, binary is just like decimal, if you're missing 8 fingers, that is. And you have only two digits, a zero and a one. And so I would need two fingers to represent that, a zero finger and a one finger. So that's how binary works. And what I'm going to do now is just walk you through an odometer exercise. And I'll tell you right now, I'm going to have 16 of these things. I'm going to travel 16 miles. And I'm doing that for a reason, which you will understand in the next lesson. But I'm going to have a decimal odometer and a binary odometer. Now, you understand how an odometer works, right? You have several wheels, and the right-hand wheel has, in a regular decimal odometer, has 10 characters on it, 0 through 9. Once it hits 9, it turns one more turn back to 0 and trips the next wheel, so that the next wheel then it becomes a 1. And then when that one gets to 9, it turns back to 0 and trips the next wheel. Now, binary odometer is going to be exactly the same, except that it only has zeros and ones on the wheel. So half of the wheel is a 0, half of the wheel is a 1. And so it only trips when it gets to 1, it's full, and it trips the next wheel over. So that's how this is going to work. Now, when you first start out at the dealership, unless the car has been test driven, of course, the decimal odometer is going to read 0. The binary odometer is going to read 0 because you've traveled 0 miles. So, well, let's travel 1 mile. Now, as I go through here, you're going to notice some coloration here. There's a blue color. Every time I trip a new wheel, I'm going to, in the decimal system, I'm going to show it as a kind of a blue here. And every time I trip a new wheel in the binary, I'm going to show it as a red. And so when, in other words, when this one trips, this will become red. When this one trips, this will become red, and so forth. So just so you know my color scheme here, but when we travel 1 mile, of course the decimal odometer reads 1 for 1 mile, and the binary odometer reads 1. But now let's travel another mile and see what happens. Well, this one, of course, you're used to this. This wheel goes from 1 to 2, but this wheel is now full, so it's going to go back to 0. And trip this wheel, which now becomes a 1. So we have a red one here because that's a new column, or a new wheel begins changing here. And so let's continue and see what happens. Well, of course, this goes to 3, as you would expect, and then this 0 rotates around to 1. That's fine, we would expect that, and we've now traveled 3 miles. So you can see now some things in binary already. You can see that 1, 0 represents 2. This is why you see the t-shirt that says there are 10 types of people in the world, those who know binary and those who don't. Well, because 10 equals 2 in binary. 11 equals 3 in binary. So let's continue. 4. Well, now we've tripped a new wheel. These were full, and so they both roll over to 0 and trips the next wheel to 1. So now you know that 100 equals 4 in binary. And, of course, 4 in decimal equals 4 miles here. When we go to 5, now, of course, we're just going to begin this process again. We're just going to begin counting these again. But it'll be a little while before we trip another one of these, before we trip another wheel. So let's just continue counting beyond 5. Sure enough, 6, of course, this one moved, rotated, it was full, and so it rotated back to 0 and tripped this one. But we don't have a new column yet. Let's go to 7, and sure enough, here's 7, but look at this. These 3 are full. It's about to trip this next wheel. So let's go on to 8 and look at that. Sure enough, these 3 roll over to 0, and this one trips over to a 1 now. So, my goodness, we've only counted 8 miles, and we've already moved over here. Well, trust me, this gets slower and slower and slower, so you don't have to worry about it, you know, tripping constantly like this. As a matter of fact, it's not going to be until we hit 16 before this goes over 1 more. So let's just continue. Sure enough, we're going to continue counting here just like we would. Oh, but now this one is full, and pretty soon this one's going to trip over to the next one. So sure enough, we have a 1 here, a new column that's been tripped over here as this 9 goes from 9 to 0. So and this is cool, by the way, that 10 is 10 in binary is 10 in decimal. I just think that's cool for some reason. I also think it's cool that 10 is 42, but that's just another story. Okay, let's continue on. 11, yeah, everything's just continuing to count just like we would expect. This wheel's starting again. 12, yeah, that wheel's continuing up. And these are just kind of repeating what they did back here, just like this is now repeating what it did back here. So let's continue. 13, sure enough, what we expect. 14, oh, this is getting full now. So let's watch out for this. This 1 is going to turn to 0. This 0 will now turn to a 1 next time, and it'll be full. So sure enough, at 15 now, these are full. And so they're all going to move over and work, because it's working on a trip the next wheel over here to a 1. And sure enough, all these roll over and trips to a 1 there. So, whoops, I forgot to uncolor this 1 over here. Oh, well, I'll have to do that later. Alright, so that's it. That's how we count in binary. So you can now see that you can look at any one of these and see what it is in decimal. But we're going to show you an easier way to do that. I don't have to memorize these. There's an easy way to calculate them. So we will do that in the next lesson. And we're also going to go back to this again, and we're going to look at some patterns to help us understand why that happens, and how we can calculate them very, very quickly. So that's it for now, and we'll see you in the next video.